Chapter 1. The Love of a Family. The sun beamed down through the trees, and a gentle breeze tickled Tommy's face as he ran down the edge of the cul-de-sac. The wind whipped through his straw-colored locks, and he laughed, trying to catch up to his brother. "I'm gonna get you, Joey," Tommy cried as he reached out to tag his brother. Joey flew out of grasp just as Tommy jumped forward with his arm outstretched. As Joey ran up the street, his brother stopped for a moment and rubbed his head. Tommy stuck his tongue between the gap in his teeth, which felt oddly comforting. He decided to surprise Joey when he came back down the street and hid behind a tree. He sucked his thumb as he waited for his brother to come running back down the road. Sure enough, after a few moments, he glimpsed Joey sprinting into sight. Tommy jumped out and began to chase Joey again. "Time out," Joey panted. "I got something in my shoe." Joey rubbed his icy blue eyes vigorously. He bent down, taking deep breaths, and his strawberry red hair swept across his puffy cheeks. Tommy stared at the boy puffing next to him as they both caught their breath. As they huffed and puffed, they listened to the far-off chirps of the birds. In the distance, Mom began to call them to come in for dinner. "I'll race you," Tommy shouted, as he turned and sprang back down the street. He glimpsed at the tall houses lining the street as he ran back down the black, worn-out road. The neighbors all cut their lawns around this time. The loud hums cut into the afternoon air like a knife. The smell of the freshly cut grass tickled his nose. Tommy flew across the gravel driveway and turned toward the staircase. The gray house's shadow provided shade for the neighborhood kids as they walked home. Joe pushed him aside and ran into the house, slamming the glass front door as he went. Tommy heard Mom call again from the confines of the kitchen. He stole one last look from the scene and walked inside. He kicked off his shoes in the foyer and slid across the polished wood floor and into the kitchen. Mom stood there, ladling spoonfuls of matzo ball soup into Joey's bowl. "What'd you do today, honeys?" she beamed as she walked over to the sink. "Tommy couldn't catch me," Joey mumbled, with pieces of matzo dribbling out of his mouth. He belted out a laugh and bits went flying. "Joe," Mom scolded, "what did I say about talking with your mouth open?" Mom quickly walked over and wiped down Joey's face and then the table. "Time for prayer. Come on, everyone. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech ha'olam." After everyone finished dinner, Tommy and Joey ran upstairs to do homework and get ready for bed. Tommy hopped into his blue spaceship pajamas and climbed up to his bunk bed he shared with Joe. Mom walked in and kissed them on the forehead. Tommy gave the room one quick glance before Mom turned out the light. He saw his comforting, checkered couch and his large white closet in the corner. Before she left, she hummed and sang, "You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray." As Tom sat awake in bed, he turned onto his stomach, propped his hands under his chin, and began his ritualistic bedtime conversation with Joey. "Joe, do you think Dad will ever come back?" "I don't know," Joe whispered. "They don't like each other, I guess." "Do you think it's our fault?" Tommy questioned. "Did we do something wrong?" This question had plagued Tommy all day long, and he could not hold it in any longer. "I don't know. I don't think so." Joey sounded half asleep already. "It's okay, Tommy. You always got me." "Love you, Joey." Tommy rolled over and got comfortable. "I love you, too." Tommy sat in the middle of two lawns, and at the edge stood a large metal fence. He could see on both of the houses' porches sat young girls about Tommy's age. The doors to both houses simultaneously flung over, and he watched as Mom strode out onto one porch and Dad strutted out onto the other. The girls both shouted, "Get rid of that boy!" Mom and Dad both turned towards Tom, daggers in their eyes, and ran full force in his direction. Terrified, he sprinted towards the fence. He clung to the fence and began to climb higher and higher, tears stinging his face as he climbed. Tommy gasped and jumped up from bed and screamed. Tears dribbled down his cheeks and his nose ran profusely. Mom scampered into the room, clutching her pink bathrobe. "What happened, baby?" she exclaimed as she pulled him off the bunk bed. She listened to Tommy's incoherent babbling and stroked his hair on the nearby couch. No one loved me," Tommy screamed, and he grabbed for his mom's neck. "No, baby, no," Mom cooed. "It's just a dream. It was just a dream." She gently caressed Tommy's face and wiped away the tears in his eyes. Joey peered over from his bed, eyes half open. "What's going on? Why is Tommy crying?" "Shh, go back to bed," Mom whispered over to Joe. She continued to cradle Tommy in her arms until his eyes closed and he drifted off to sleep. Next morning, Tommy awoke, lying curled up on his checkered sofa in the left-hand corner of the bedroom. The boy glimpsed over to the lower bunk and saw Joey's arm dangling off the edge. Mom walked in and gently shook Joey. "Time to get up, Angel. Let's get ready for school," she sang. "Breakfast is downstairs." She tiptoed back out of the room. As Joey and Tommy silently hopped down the stairs, they could smell the scent of eggs and bacon before they reached the kitchen. They sat down at the rectangular table and attacked the food with their utensils. After they finished the meal, Mom ushered them into the foyer and helped